Hi, my name is Rami Radi, and I'm a solutions architect in Intel's Data Center Management Solutions Group. In this video, I'll be going over some of the latest features of Intel Data Center Manager, or Intel DCM, specifically those that focus on improving data center sustainability. Remember to follow the links in the description below to learn more about Intel DCM. In our previous video, our group's general manager, Ajay Garg, discussed how Intel DCM provides a 3-in-1 solution to measure, project, and control the carbon footprint of data centers in order to address the industry's demand for greener data centers and to comply with today's stricter carbon emission regulations. So let's use a live DCM instance to look at some of those sustainability features in more depth. Once you log onto the Intel DCM web console, you'll see the main dashboard, which consists of customizable gadgets that are designed to give you a holistic view of your data centers. One of these gadgets will show the annual and monthly actual and projected carbon emissions for your data centers. The carbon emissions of a device is calculated based on the power consumption of that device, which Intel DCM monitors in real time, the data center's known PUE, or power usage effectiveness, and the carbon intensity, which is a measure of the amount of carbon dioxide or other greenhouse gases that are emitted per unit energy consumed, which is typically expressed in kilograms of CO2 per kilowatt hour. Clicking on the Sustainability tab on the left takes us to a more detailed view of this graph that shows us the carbon emissions relative to any set thresholds. So in this case, we see that while we're still good on this month's carbon emissions, it seems that based on this trajectory, we'll be reaching the set annual threshold by October. DCM takes note of that and can send notifications and alerts as we get closer to that threshold. A first quick and easy preemptive measure we could take is to click on this tab to see which servers in the environment are underutilized and unnecessarily consuming power and space. And you can see how much carbon emissions can be reduced by consolidating or taking down such servers. Clicking on the server will take you to a page that will show you its details, including its inventory information, its health status, the status of its subcomponents, its fault history, its sensor readings and utilization details, as well as its temperature, power, and carbon emission details over a period of time, which can be customized from anywhere from an hour all the way up to a year. DCM can also aggregate the carbon emissions as you move up the physical hierarchy of your environment. So while we were looking at the carbon emissions of this particular server over time, you can also see that on the rack, row, room, and data center levels. You can also click on the Devices tab, then click on Groups to create logical groups of devices regardless where they exist in the physical hierarchy. For example, I've created here a group of servers running a specific workload, and this can allow DCM to calculate the carbon emissions even on a workload level. Another action we can take is click on the Sustainability tab and look at the cooling analysis to see if we are unnecessarily overcooling some of the rooms in our data centers. If most of the servers in a room are running cold, it might be a good opportunity to safely increase the set point temperature to reduce the energy spent on cooling. This is not really the case in this room in particular, but it was very easy for us to verify that. We can also click on the Server Characteristics tab and then click on Server Replacement Analysis to do a what-if carbon emissions analysis that allows us to see the impact of removing, adding, or replacing servers in your environment's carbon footprint. For example, if I want to add 5 new servers of this model in this data center, we see that would significantly increase our carbon emissions and we would exceed our annual threshold much sooner. And this kind of information can have a significant impact on server procurement decisions. These are just some of the features that Intel DCM offers to aid data center managers in measuring, modeling, and controlling the operational carbon footprint of data centers. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to check out our other videos and stay tuned for more videos on Intel DCM. And don't forget to visit our website, intel.com/DCM, for more information. You can also try Intel DCM for free by downloading it from the following link. And if you have any questions or if you'd like to schedule a more in-depth demo of Intel DCM, please don't hesitate to contact us at dcm@intel.com. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to the Intel Software Channel for more content like this.